Hi, Alex here from Rebelloper.com, and in this video I'm going to talk about why I will never use iCloud again. So let's get started. So why shouldn't you use iCloud? It is a great platform. It is Apple's very own cloud platform. Of course, there are others like Firebase, but if you want to have a Mac app or a tvOS Mac and an iOS app and you want them to work together, iCloud seems to be the only and the sanest option out there. Well, today I'm going to talk about a little lame secret of Apple's about iCloud that you wouldn't believe it exists, but I found it out on my own. So I will tell you so you don't have to, and believe me, you will never look at iCloud again, the same again. So what happened is that we built an app, and of course it uses iCloud, and it is a huge app, and we got a few of our users come and sign up, and it has gradually gained popularity. Now what we wanted to do is to sell this app because there were many offers, and we did. So what we wanted to do next is transfer the app. Now this is where it all went down the hill, because it turns out you cannot transfer apps to other accounts when in your app there is iCloud enabled. So whether if it's the current build, current version, or any other previous version has iCloud enabled in it, you just simply cannot transfer it to another account. Well, basically you just simply cannot sell it to anybody. It's yours and it is yours forever. Now this issue, as I found out, is going on for years, and it doesn't seem that Apple will resolve this issue. Okay, now there were some alternatives. So what if I disabled iCloud and uploaded a new version? Well, as I have already told you, if any of the builds had iCloud enabled, then you just simply cannot transfer the app. You just simply don't have. So if I just take a look here, I have a ready for sale app. Just scroll down under the App Store app information. Here you have transfer app. Well, when you have iCloud enabled, you don't have that option. Okay, now our next idea was, and this is what we kind of made because we didn't have any other choice, is that we needed to delete the whole app. Well, we needed to remove it from sale and then delete it from App Store Connect. And then on the other person's account, we needed to resubmit as a brand new app. Okay, that is what we actually did, but we lost all of our users. So there is no way that we could transfer the users from one iCloud account to the other. So that was the main drawback of why I will never ever use iCloud again. If they fix it, I will give it a go again. But for now, no iCloud, please. So if you run into this issue, you will most probably have this warning: you can't transfer this app because of the following reasons. iCloud enabled, you can only transfer apps that aren't iCloud enabled. And the documentation states, as this Stack Overflow question shows us, make sure that the app uses only technology and content that can be transferred. So iCloud cannot be transferred. No version of the app can use an iCloud entitlement. So that's that. We learned our lesson. No more iCloud. Thank you. Now, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoy our videos, go ahead and subscribe. Now it's your turn. Do you have any iCloud-enabled apps on the App Store, or did you run into this problem? If you do, go ahead and comment down below, give us a shout out, and what is your experience? I will answer to each and every comment down below as soon as possible. And as always, I will see you in the next one.